Welcome to a video about a club that disappeared very quickly after being created. This is a very short story of FC Bolsover. The club was initially founded in 2013, but they were denied entry into Central Midlands Alliance League. This was due to FC Bolsover not meeting ground rating criteria. The ground was Langriff Road in Shirebrook, which they ground shared with FC Shirebrook Town. It has 2,000 capacity, but before this ground, they used an actual literal school, which was called Shirebrook Academy. And the only information I could find on the sports facilities at Shirebrook Academy is that it has 170 car parking spaces, it has a grass pitch, and is not flood-fit. In 2016, the club was re-established and joined the Central Midlands League North, and they won the league at the first time of asking, finishing the season on 71 points, which is outrageous for their first season as a club. But that is only two more than Claycross Town FC. The goals scored was just staggering. FC Bolsover scored a whopping 148 goals in 30 games and only conceded 31 goals in that time. That is roughly 4.93 goals scored a game on average, and roughly 1.03 goals conceded every game on average. During the season, they racked up an impressive 22 wins, 5 draws and 3 losses. That same season, they managed to get into the League Cup semi-finals, along the way beating Claycross Town 5-1 at home. Then they beat Tiverton Reserves 5-2 away, and in the quarterfinals they beat Swanwick Pentridge Road 3-2 away. Then unfortunately, they lost in a big 4-0 loss to Hucknall at the neutral venue. The neutral venue was Blidworth Welfare. Next season, the 17-18 season, it wasn't such a great year. They got 6 points deducted for fielding a suspended player in their two early season wins. 2-0 against Winnerton Rangers and 5-0 against Swallow Nest, both at Langriff Road, just 3 days apart. That point deduction nearly got them relegated, as they finished on just 30 points across the 42 game season, picking up 11 wins, 3 draws, 28 losses, and finishing the season on minus 76 goal difference. The Cup also didn't go great for Bolsover. They lost in the first round to Knaresborough Town 1-0 at home. They did participate in the FA Vars for the first time during the 17-18 season. They entered the second qualifying round and played Milton Town away. They comfortably dispatched of them 4-1. In the next round, they got drawn against Deeping Rangers at home in the first round proper. They went on to lose to them 3-1. It went from bad to worse for FC Bolsover as they finished 19th out of 20 teams. They had no points deductions either. It was just generally a very bad year for the team. Picking up 9 wins all season, that was accompanied with 4 draws and 25 losses. But the icing on the cake was being on minus 61 goal difference, the worst in the entire division. But they were subsequently reprieved of relegation, but got moved to the East Midlands Counties League. That same season, FC Bolsover entered round 3 of the League Cup and they subsequently lost 3-2 to Penistone Church at home. This same season was the second ever in the FA Vars, they took on Leicester Nirvana at home in the second round of qualification, but they lost to them 2-1. That last season was their final season, as they got moved to the East Midlands Counties League, but they resigned from the league in the FA Vars and folded for unknown reasons. I actually looked across a lot of old newspaper articles and I genuinely could not find any reason for FC Bolsover folding. And their FA Vars draw against Long Eaton United was given straight to Long Eaton as a walkover. This also meant there's only one team relegated from East Midlands Counties Football League Premier Division. The team that would have got relegated if it wasn't for FC Bolsover's resignation would have been Shirebrook Town FC, who they shared Langriff Road with. They have since been reformed to the youth football side, which is to the benefit of grassroots football in England and obviously non-league football as well. Another example of a team like FC Bolsover is my local side, MK City, my closest side actually, they play 5 minutes away from me, who have been in a very similar situation to FC Bolsover, folding and starting all over as a youth football team and then eventually getting men's teams back and things like that. If you'd like to see a video on MK City, let me know in the comments below. It'd be a really interesting one for me to research and to share with the wider world. But all this happened under Chairman Benjamin Thomas and manager Matt Chatfield. But unfortunately, I was unable to find any footballing related information on either of these people. But big thanks to fchd.info for the facts and information I used on this video. And go check out that website, which I think is linked in the description, for facts on every football club in the UK. But on that note, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this very short, but hopefully quite sound video for you. But yeah, please tell me in the comments below if you'd like to see a video on MK City or any other non-league or football league or any team in the UK, really. I enjoy researching any football. But yeah, on that note, thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. Peace.